Midweek games are always tough just because it's you gotta kind of flip the page over and go to the midweek game on Tuesday. And it's on the road, you know, in Memphis against Memphis. I mean, it's going to be a tough game to win.
We just come off a big weekend beating Tennessee three times. So having to, you know, kind of carrying that over into the midweek, playing well, you know, for a stretch of games other than just kind of one game at a time is huge for us.
Ball tapped, slowly past the mound. Second baseman charges, gets it, flips it, throws it over the head of the first baseman, safe as Mangum. And he just drove one deep to left field, and it is going to go for a home run, or did it? No. It's off the wall. It hit the top of the wall and came back down. And there's a ground ball up the middle, hits the bag, goes into center field. That will drive in a pair. Mississippi State, three straight hits to start the ball game. The stretch on the pitch. Drives it in to the gap in left center field and going to send it all the way to the warning track. One run is scored, and here comes another. He'll score without a play on a two-run double by Josh Lovelady, who just keeps finding a way to get big hits for the Bulldogs.
I thought it was a quality midweek opponent for us to play with an SEC type of arm on the mound, where it just continued to allow our team to face great arms and just keep getting better and better against quality stuff.
There's a drive. If it stays fair, it's trouble. It's down the line and left, and it is gone. Gridley's fifth home run of the year. Bulldogs, if they can put this one in the book, a good way to start the week. Obviously a challenge ahead against a good Ole Miss ball club, and they're playing at Oxford. Here's the pitch. Struck him out, swinging, or did he? Yes, he did. Swing and a miss, and this ball game is over.
Outstanding win tonight, man. Woo! Outstanding win tonight. I love the way we're playing, man. We've got a lot of energy on the field. It looks like you guys are playing with a ton of confidence. Okay, you took care of business tonight. We've got a really big weekend ahead of us, man, okay? It's going to be an outstanding rivalry, man. It's the first time that I've had a chance to participate in it, okay? But I've been in the stands a lot of times, and I've seen there be 12,000, 14,000, 15,000 people there. It's a really big rivalry, man, okay? I love the way we're playing, dude. I love it, man, and I know we're going to go up there and we're going to freaking put something on it.
We had a really long rain delay the previous weekend against Tennessee, so I actually had a better feel that we were going to come out and play really well against Ole Miss, even though we didn't start on time. Our guys stayed really loose before the ball game. They didn't get uptight. They weren't nervous. They were just ready for the challenge.
I had been there 2 years ago, and it's obviously one of the more hostile environments in the league. Fans are right on top of you, so you know they're going to be talking to you the whole time, trying to get in your head. And we kind of went through it at Arkansas, the same type of environment, so I think that really prepared us for it.
Get yourself ready to play, man, okay? No BP on the field, no in and out, all those kind of things. It doesn't matter, man. When the guy says play ball, we gotta find our way to get ready to play. This team is not better than us. Book it. You understand me? They are not better than us. Troy playing in these kind of matchups, man. This is what this is about. This is state bragging rights. Bring your A game, okay? Get in the middle of the ring, and throw some punches against these guys. They'll fold clean, crisp, fundamental sound baseball for 9 innings.
Evening of exciting baseball. Southeastern Conference, it doesn't get any better than SEC baseball. And MacArthur's ready to pitch. Mangum's at the plate, and he's inside with his fastball, and we're underway.
Game one in an SEC series, you always have guys on the mound that are really, really hard to hit.
Out of delivery, and it's on the inside corner. Strike three is called, and that'll do it in the inning.
We knew it was going to be a pitcher's duel, probably. We knew Connor was going to go out there and give us a chance to win. We knew their guy had been throwing really well, so you know, we just kind of knew there was going to be a fight for 9 innings.
Connor Pilkington stretches and pitches. And it is driven in the air, deep in the outfield, and it is going to go to the wall, and that'll drive in the run. Dillard will get a pair, and Ole Miss has a 1-0 lead in the contest. Two on, two outs here in the bottom of the fifth, 1-0, Ole Miss leading in the ballgame. Pitch is lined towards right center, and it's in there for at least extra bases and will get two runs home. Runner going to third. Throw is going to be not in time. It'll be a triple for Blackman, and Ole Miss with another big two-out base hit. Jacob Barton trying to keep it where it is and give the Bulldogs a chance. He got a strikeout on a swing and a miss, and he struck out the first two he's faced.
Our bullpen stepped up for us in so many ways in this, you know, in these last seven games we've won. They've been throwing, you know, tons of strikes, you know, challenging the other hitters, and they're just getting the job done.
Hunter Vansaw is the pinch hitter, left-handed hitter. Ground ball hit to third, grabbed and thrown to second for one. Relay to first is not in time. They get the lead runner. Runner going, pitch coming, ground ball hit to the side and is going to roll into left center field for a base hit, and I send the runner, Vansaw, who was running on a pitch around the third base.
Anytime Rooker's in the box, anything can happen. He can change the game in one swing.
Down 3-0 in the top half of the seventh inning, and the pitch on the way. And he let him swing the bat, and he hammers it, and it's fair down to the left field corner. And that is going to score a pair, I think. Here comes Mangum. Here comes a throw. It's going to be close. He is safe at the plate as he came in head first. And they turned him loose on 3-0, and he delivered with a rocket into the left field corner. And suddenly, this is a one-run ball game.
Getting the 3-0 green light is a huge boost of confidence for me. I appreciated Coach, you know, putting his faith in me to swing away right there. You know, I was just looking for a fastball middle end that I could do some damage to.
We were down 3 runs at the time. I felt like I could go green light with him because he has such a good control and feel for the strike zone right now. He doubled down the left field line. He did exactly what we needed him to do from a team standpoint to kind of pick our team up, give us the confidence we needed moving forward, and then we started to roll after that.
So Gridley is going to draw an intentional pass, and he will be on base. Pick number 24, Cole Gordon, has picked up a bat, and he looks to be the next hitter.
He needed a jump start offensively. I felt like we had some guys on the bench that could really come into the ball game and give us a quality at bat. I wanted to get Cole Gordon a swing. His BPs have been really great the last 2 or 3 weeks, and I just felt like he earned the opportunity to go up there and swing.
Pitch on the way, and he hammers it through the hole into right field. That's a base hit. Here comes a throw. Here comes a runner, and he is safe at the plate, and the game is tied. And Cole Gordon, a pinch hit opportunity, delivers with a big base hit to right field.
If you mentally keep yourself in the game the whole game, you know, that gives you the best advantage. And Cole Gordon, you know, comes in and gets a huge, huge base hit for us. And, you know, he stayed ready the whole game, and I think that's why he got it done.
And he popped him up. Rooker's over near the stands calling for it, and he's got it for out number 3. Watson fouls out to the first baseman of the inning. We played 8. We head to the 9th. There's a ball in the air, and it's going to drop in left center field, and he's going to get a couple. He's headed for second. They'll pick it up and throw it in. And Jake Mangum with a double gives the Bulldogs a scoring opportunity here in the 9th inning. Breaking ball, grounded up the middle. They get to it. They get one. The throw to first is not in time. They got the out at second base, and that was it. And it is first and third now. And the guy at the plate is Cole Gordon. But could he do it twice?
When I was on third base, you know, we needed that run to take the lead in the top of the 9th. I knew if any pass ball was coming, I would be really aggressive and try to score.
And the pitch. And ball gets away, swing and a miss. He's going to score the run, and Gordon's going to be safe. Mississippi State has taken the lead in the ball game on a strikeout wild pitch.
It was a 94-mile-an-hour fastball that the bottom basically fell out of, and the guy in the ball ends up hitting off of Cooper Johnson's mitt to the backstop, and we score that run.
We were all really excited, obviously, to get that the 4th run across the board, I guess it was, and, you know, kind of put ourselves in a position to win the game.
Bottom of the 9th with 2 on and nobody out, down by a run. Bulldogs got the lead run across the plate. Now the bunt back to the mound. The play is the first. The throw is in time. Self feels the position and gets the out. The runners have moved into scoring position. Stretch by Riley Self. The pitch coming. Inside corner at the knees. Canizero out of the dugout. He's going to make a pitching change. He's going to come in with a one ball, two strike count. He's going to bring the right-hander into the bullpen.
I felt like Riley Self, when he was on the mound, could get really weak contact from the hitter. But Olenek had already seen him previously, and we were deep in the at-bat there. But I didn't necessarily think Riley Self had enough at that time to strike him out. But then once we got to two strikes, I knew we had Spencer Price and his wipeout slider available in the bullpen.
I wasn't really nervous. I just knew what I had to do and tried to execute it.
Bulldogs with a 4-3 lead in jeopardy on the pitch. Check swing, and he went around, and he tacks him out. He wanted to run. He went around on a pitch in the dirt, and Skelton tagged the runner as he left the plate and tried to streak to an open first base, and now it's two outs.
Getting the second out of an inning is huge, because all you got to do is just one more. You can do that anyway possible, ground out, fly out, another strikeout. Whatever may happen, happens. It's a lot easier that way.
Price is ready. Skelton sets up, pitch on the way, swinging strike three, and this ball game is over. Price has struck out Bortles to end it with the bases loaded, and the Bulldogs get a 4-3 win here on opening night. Boy, this was a gallant comeback and a big win on the road for Mississippi State.
The first game is really, really important because it sets the tone for the whole weekend. You can't sweep a weekend unless you win game one. Another win, it was a big one, and I was more ready for that one's over with. Now we got to focus on the next two.
That was out freaking. Hey, that's what we talk about all the time about playing a full 9 innings of baseball. This win is on you guys, man. Okay? This was outstanding job of playing for 3 hours, 9 innings, and not giving up. And when your number's called off the bench, being ready to perform. This was a gigantic win for us. Continue to build on it. Confidence, confidence, confidence. And guess what? We come right back out here again tomorrow. So what we did tonight has no bearing on what happens tomorrow. It's the second battle of three. Enjoy it for the rest of the night. And when we wake up in the morning, we have a new fight ahead of us.
Hi, Dak Prescott here. After losing my mom to colon cancer in 2013, it became personal to me. It is the second leading cancer killer. The good thing though, it can be prevented, it can be treated, and it can be beaten. So if you're 50 or older, get screened. Do it for me and do it for yourself.
Come see us at Gastroenterology Associates or Baptist Cancer Center.
Locations in Columbus and Starkville.
At CSpire, I work for Roger. Some months he uses more data, some months he uses less. And I thought, why pay for data he doesn't use? So CSpire's unlimited plan now gives you cash back on your bill. Now, when Roger uses less data, he pays less. Unlimited with cash back on your bill. That works for Roger. And CSpire works for you. CSpire, customer inspired.
Felt like our guys, by winning that first game Thursday night, you know, realized that we were the better team in that series, and our guys played really with a lot of confidence and a lot of conviction every single day that we had what it took to win the series.
I don't want you to forget about yesterday's ball game. I don't want you to think about the win at the end. I want you to think about the process and what you had to go through to have that result. We were a different team last night once you guys realized that you're the better team. They're ranked, we're not. Let's flip the script on these guys. Tunnel vision, we're in battle two of the weekend. You won the first battle, it doesn't mean you've won the whole thing yet. Go out and win the second battle and you'll love it, man.
And Ole Miss, with the bases loaded, have a golden opportunity, a left-handed hitter, Tim Rowe, due to come to the plate.
I thought the first inning was the time that we needed to stop Ole Miss from scoring. At any point in the game, the ball game can be won or lost, and I felt like the game was on the line right there in the first inning. And I felt like Jacob Barton had been pitching really well lately, and I wanted to get him into the ball game as soon as possible so he could stop Ole Miss from scoring.
And off the stretch, and he delivers, and he struck him out on a breaking ball. Good down and in breaking ball, and Rose strikes out, and now Zabowski will be the batter. Breaking ball, roll towards short. Gridley gets it. He's going to get to the bag and just barely beat the runner. Barely beat the runner to the bag, but he got there in time.
I guess game two, you know, we're up 1-0 in the series, and then bottom of the first, they get bases loaded real quick, and we're able to hold them. That was huge. Kind of really killed their momentum that game too.
Jacob Barton did an outstanding job coming in right there and kind of just weathering the storm. Obviously, they got some guys on early, and they felt in their dugout that they were going to be able to take an early lead right there. And Barton did a really good job of coming in and kind of shutting the door and keeping it 0-0, keeping kind of, you know, their little rally at bay and just kind of giving us a chance to get reacclimated and get back in the game offensively.
Strike pitch, and he tries to go the other way. The little blooper down the line, fair ball, and it's going to roll onto the track and score Lovelady. It'll be a double for Brent Rooker. He made a great two-strike adjustment, and he just tried to put a ball in play. Didn't try to do anything but get the barrel of the bat out there, and he hits a little fly ball that was about a couple of feet fair down that right field line and drives in the run. We're all tied up at a run apiece. There's a drive and down the line. It's a fair ball. It is gone. It just cleared the wall. And that is a two-run homer for Cody Brown. Cody Brown with his third home run of the year, and Mississippi State on top for the first time tonight by a score of 3-2. Parkinson gives up the home run, and Cody Brown, the senior from Biloxi, has to feel awfully good about that one.
You know, he's been a part of the Mississippi State Ole Miss rivalry for 5 years now, and he knows how big it is, and he knows how important it is for us to beat Ole Miss. And, you know, for him to have that moment where he hits the home run was great for him.
He just got to the plate, and he got good pitches to hit, and he drove them. He did exactly what he had to do. And, you know, Cody's a great hitter, and he's a great baseball player. He always steps up and gets the job done for us. He's done that since I've been here 2 years now.
Now he looks and the runner's going, the pitch coming, a swing and a miss, a throw down, and it goes off of the runner, ricochets into left, and Poole gets up and runs over to third base. There's a smash in the left field and a diving attempt, and the ball goes past Seamster, and it's going to go to the wall. It scores the run, and Lovelady's trying to get three, and the throw to third base. No, and they hold it up. The cutoff man decided not to make the throw. Josh Lovelady with a single and a run scored, and now a triple and a run driven in. A huge two-out hit.
Lovelady's a great leader for our team. Lovelady got the freaking job done.
Josh has been outstanding defensively. He blocks the baseball extremely well, and he's been swinging a really good bat, and he just gives us another weapon offensively right now in our lineup.
3-1 pitch. There's a high drive deep to left, and that ball is gone. And it was a no-doubter off the bat as Rooker hits his ninth home run of the year, and Mississippi State has taken a 5-2 lead in the ballgame.
Rooker's home run, I think it left the park in like 0.2 seconds.
Anytime you're in conference and you're playing on the road, you know that team's going to make a run at some point, and you know, you want to get as many insurance runs as you can, so really you're looking to get a 3-4-5 run lead.
You know, when you get opportunities to score runs, you can't let them pass. You have to be able to execute at a high level to win in the SEC, and we've really done that the last two weekends.
Runner at second base. Price at the belt. And a breaking ball, and did he go around? He did. He didn't check it in time, and this ball game is over. Bulldogs have won a series in Oxford for the first time since 2011. And Mississippi State takes two on the road from Ole Miss. Price picks up his eighth save of the season. And Mississippi State wins this one by a score of 5-3.
This was another terrific 9 innings of baseball, man. Okay? Hey, it got real hairy there in the first or second inning, man. But that's what you do, man. When your number is called out of the bullpen, you come out, you pound the strike zone, and you make them swing the bat. Outstanding job by our bullpen today. Congratulations on a road victory series in the SEC. That is huge, fellas. Gigantic. Now we've turned our sights and a chance to do something really freaking special for the second straight weekend, okay? Battle two, we have won, okay? We got a big one tomorrow, man. Come out and play great, clean baseball. This team to come out fast today, right? Come out fast. So what we need to do is match their energy level. We've really got to be dialed in and focused early. And I'm telling you, weather the early storm, crisis management early in the ball game. If we get into a full ball game, nine innings against these guys, where we weather it early, we'll beat them. We've already won the series. You did that last night. Today's battle three, okay? You want bragging rights in your city and your state and all those kind of things? Take care of these guys today. You won the first battle, you won the second battle, now you've got a big one on day three.
Getting an opportunity for the third consecutive weekend to draw the start in the third game of the weekend series. And there's a ball hit right back up the middle, a base hit for Olenek. The pitch, it is a line shot into left field, and that will drive in the run. So Bortles with an RBI single puts Ole Miss on top early.
The first inning, you know, I left everything kind of belt high, chest high, and they hit it. Two hits that first inning, you know. It was both elevated pitches. You know, the second inning on, I thought I'd rather throw a ball low than a strike high. And I think that kind of lowered my tunnel vision a little lower and kept the ball low and I trusted my movement. And I was able to trust my off-speed pitches too.
And now his pitch on the way, and he struck him out swinging. He got good location, hit the outside corner, and Kessinger swung and missed it.
You could really tell that the Ole Miss-Mississippi State rivalry is big for Jake. And then when I was able to put the ball in his hands on Saturday, where he had the ball, he was on the mound, he controlled the outcome. He pitched with a lot of confidence. He threw his fastball for strikes. He threw his breaking ball for strikes. It was a really gutsy performance from our All-American.
Drive is going to drop over the head of Kessinger. He tried to run it down in short left field and lead off base hit for Josh Lovelady. There's a drive into the left field corner. It is a fair ball. That will get Lovelady home. Runner around third is going to be held up, and now they drop the ball and he goes back. That's the 17th double of the year for the Bulldogs. Brent Rooker, he ties up the ball game.
First time I saw him, he attacked me primarily fastball changeup. So I figured he was going to probably come back and try to sneak a breaker over for strike one because I hadn't seen that pitch yet, which is exactly what he did. I hit a first pitch slider that he kind of left up in the zone a little bit, and I was just able to, you know, see it early and put a good swing on it, and you know, that get that first run across the board is huge.
There's a ball driven in the right field. That'll be extra bases. Going to go to the wall. Cody Brown is headed to second. He's going to stop there with a stand-up double. Boy, Cody has swung the bat well this weekend. His pitch. And it's bunted to the first base side. Pitcher gets it and going to throw to the covering second baseman. Nice sacrifice. Well bunted ball by McNamee. He moves the base runner. Cody Brown's at third. One out of the inning now. There's a drive into left. And Dillard will catch it, but they'll tag Cody Brown. The throw will not be nearly in time. And that's a good sacrifice fly for Lovelady as he drives in the run. The Bulldogs take a lead in the ballgame.
That's a textbook offensive inning with Cody getting on base, Mack doing his job moving him over, and then Love just, you know, continuing to swing a really hot bat, getting that run in, you know, having different guys contribute up and down the lineup, which is a really good sign for our team.
We double, we bunt him over, and we drive him in with a sac fly. Those are the types of things that we talk about all the time, needing to take care of the little things to help win ball games in this league.
When something's asked of you, just get the job done. Just do your job, and then it helps the team win. And ultimately, that was the deciding factor of the game. He gave us a lead 2-1 early in the game, and then that was it.
The wind up of the pitch by Self. Ground ball past the third baseman into left field, a base hit. Just a big bouncer that was in the right spot, but Ole Miss has the tying run on base with nobody out here in the ninth inning. Zero is going to make a pitching change. He's decided that with a count of 2 balls and 2 strikes, he's going to go to the bullpen with Mississippi State leading 2-1 in the bottom of the ninth.
It was the same philosophy where I thought Spencer Price could strike Bortles out.
Bortles lines one back up the middle, first and second, nobody out.
Just kind of had to bear down, no more mistakes. Had to kind of get myself going a little bit and just had to show everybody I could do it.
There's ball 4, Dillard is on base. Bases are loaded for Ole Miss with one out of the bottom of the ninth.
I actually told Rooker and Gridley, I was like, man, you know, we got a 1-run lead. Going to the bottom of the ninth, I mean, the way we win games, you know it's gonna get interesting. You know it's gonna get hairy. And, you know, I actually told him, I was like, hey, watch us get the bases loaded and get out of it.
And the pitch, high pop up. Out behind third, foul territory. Alexander's got it out, number 2.
You know, once we had runners all over the bases, Spencer Price really started to make quality pitches.
Bases jammed. Price ready. Rowe digs in. And here it comes. Hard hit ball. A great dive by Rucker. He's going to get to the bag and end the ball game on a great defensive play. An unbelievable defensive play by Rucker on a smash off the bat of Rowe. It doesn't get any better than that, folks. He made a diving play right on the line and then sprung to his feet and raced to the bag. And the Bulldogs take 3 in Oxford for the first time since 2003. What a play to end another great ball game here at Swayze Field. A 2-1 Bulldog victory, a 3-game sweep. They've now won 7 in a row.
You know, figuring the ball was going to come to either me or Cody. And I remember seeing it off the bat, and then he hit it hard, and then I just kind of dove one way, and it happened to end up in my glove.
It happened so fast, but yet it seems like everything's moving so slow. When the guy puts the swing on it and hits the ball down the first baseline, my immediate thought was, oh no. But then obviously you see Rooker leave his feet, pick the ball, sticks in his pocket. It just went from an extreme oh no to massive jubilation in a matter of tenths of a second.
And you know, I see Rooker get up and I see Hunter Stovall jump out of the dugout, freaking 8 feet in the air. And that's when I knew he caught it, seeing Stovall freaking fly out of the dugout.
That's how you win baseball games in the SEC, okay? It's got to be locked in. We are here for a purpose. I told you guys this was going to be a really hard freaking game today. Those guys gave you everything they had. Let's break it down. Let's clean out the dugout. Let's get on the bus. Congratulations, man. This weekend was all you guys were awesome.
There's nothing better than being at home in front of your home fans, especially in a conference weekend, a big-time weekend like Super Bulldog weekend against a really, really quality opponent in Kentucky.
I have a lot of confidence in our team. I love the way we're playing right now, and we'll be ready for the challenge that both of these teams are going to present us this week.